चैप्टर 8 श्रीनिवास रामानुजन पार्ट 1 यूनिट 8 श्रीनिवास रामानुजन इन एक्टिविटी 1 नंबर आर फन लेट्स प्ले अ गेम ऑफ नंबर्स इन पेयर टू प्ले दिस गेम हियर आर द स्टेप्स टू बी फॉलोड नाउ दिस इज अ नंबर गेम एंड टू प्ले दिस नंबर गेम दे हैव बिलो गिवन द 5 स्टेप्स वी कैन प्ले दिस गेम विथ You can play this game with your parents, with your friends. Okay? Step 1, ask your friends to think of a number. Step 2, tell him to add 7 to that number. Step 3, ask him to multiply the added number by 2, then subtract 4 from the number. Step 4, ask him to tell you the number that he has arrived at. Step 5, now you divide this number by 2 and subtract 5 out of that number. At the end, you will get the number your friend or your parents have thought of. Now, this is a very simple game you can play and do. Let me know how was your experience when we'll have interactive session. Activity 2, identify this famous scientist, name them and find the information to complete the table. So the first picture is of a very famous person, we all know it, and it is Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, and he was an aeronautical engineer and he has launched satellites. Okay, the second picture is of C.V. Raman, and he was a genius in the subject matter of physics, and he has done a great work, and his work is also known as Raman effect. Okay, the third picture is of our own very own Vikram Sarabhai ji, and his he was also a great he has also done a great work in the subject matter of physics, and he has done his researches in nuclear science. Okay, and the fourth picture is of Venkatraman Ramakrishnan. Okay, He has a great knowledge and command over the subject matter of biochemistry and biophysics, and he has done a lot of research work in atomic structure of ribosome. Okay, so I will be giving you the PDF, I will be sending you where you can fill up the data over these four personalities in this column. Moving to activity 3, the main part of our today's topic, Srinivas Ramanujan, the man who lived with numbers. So this entire chapter is of a mathematical genius named Srinivas Ramanujan. We celebrate 125th birth anniversary of Srinivas Ramanujan in 2012, inaugurating the year-long celebration at the University of Madras on December 26, Dr. Manmohan Singh declared 2012 as a National Mathematical Year and Ramanujan's birthday as a National Mathematics Day. A commemorative stamp is honored on Srinivas Ramanujan was issued on the occasion. So this in 2012, the year-long celebration was taken at a University of Madras, because it was the 125th birth anniversary of a mathematical genius, Srinivas Ramanujan. And our ex-Prime Minister, Dr. Manmohan Singh, has declared 2012 as a National Mathematical Year and his birthday as a National Mathematics Day. On this day, a stamp was also issued in the honor of, a postal stamp was also issued in the honor of Srinivas Ramanujan. Once a mathematics period of class 8 was in progress in a small school in Tamil Nadu. Any number when divided by the same number becomes unit, said the teacher. But sir, what if the number is 0? So once there was a class 8 mathematics period was going on, and in the school of Tamil Nadu, and the teacher was teaching, and teacher passed this statement from the book that the same number becomes the unit. Any number when divided by the same number, it becomes the unit. But a child asked a question, sir, what if the number is 0? Asked a thin dark eye ball, eye boy, leaving his teacher speechless. When this boy asked this question to a teacher was speechless in nature. The boy was Srinivas Ramanujan, the mathematical genius who made extraordinary contribution to mathematical analysis. Number theory, infinite series and continued fractions. So the boy who asked this question to that teacher was Srinivas Ramanujan, who had made a great contribution to the mathematics and a topics in mathematics like number theory, infinite series and continued fractions. During his short lifetime of 32 years, Ramanujan independently compiled nearly 3,900 results. Now what happened? Srinivas Ramanujan, he had a very short life. He died at the age of 32. But in this age of his 32 years, he has done lot of work and nearly 3,900 results, equations and identities were mostly cleared by him. So he has solved so many problems and equations. Born on December 22nd, 1887. So Ramanujan was born on 22nd December 1887 in a poor family in Erode, Tamil Nadu. Ramanujan was interested in maths right from his childhood. So he was born on 22nd December 1887 in a poor family in Erode, and this is in Tamil Nadu. Okay, and he right from his childhood he was very interested in the subject matter of maths. He demonstrated unusual mathematical skills at school, winning accolades and award. By the time he was 14, he could solve problems in trigonometry which even college students cannot. So when he was of 14 years and in his schooling era, he won many awards and he could solve the trigonometry problems, questions in the mathematics. This is one of the genre in mathematics, one of the mathematical subject area, okay, which a college student also cannot solve, but he was able to solve. Strange as it may sound, the school boy who stood first in his class and could teach trigonometry to students in college was unable to secure pass mark in any subject. He was very, very, very good in maths. His maths was very powerful and he can teach maths and these trigonometry questions to college students. But at the same time, when it comes to the other subject, he was not able to pass or gain a passing marks. Okay, so his other subjects was not that great the way it was in maths. Other than mathematics, when he entered college, he appeared three times for his FA examination but failed each time because he could not get passing marks in English. See, he was so good in mathematics, but when for getting admission in college, he applied three times, but he was not able to go through these examination and he failed each time because he cannot get a passing marks in English. Dejected by his college education in Tamil Nadu, Ramanujan wrote to G.H. Hardy, an acclaimed mathematician of his time. When he tried a lot in Tamil Nadu to get an education and he was not able to enter the college, then he wrote a letter to the famous mathematician G.H. Hardy at Cambridge. Okay. And he got admission in Cambridge in 1930 and he forwarded all his researches over there. Impressed by his work, the university admitted Ramanujan without any application in 1914. So university was so happy with the work and researches and they were so impressed by his work that without any application form, without any entrance, they admitted Ramanujan to the Cambridge University. While at Cambridge, he published many papers on a variety of topics. He was elected to the London Mathematical Society. So when he was in Cambridge, he had written many papers on a variety of topics in maths and he also got selected in a London Mathematical Society. He became a fellow of Royal Society in 1918. So he also became a member of Royal Society in 1918. And he was elected for his investigation in epileptic functions and the theory of numbers. So his work in elliptic functions and theory of numbers was so great that because of his work he was selected in the Royal Society. However, the strenuous work, inadequate food and loneliness took their toll on his health, and Ramanujan fell ill in 1970. He returned to India in 1990 and died on April 26, 1920. So, life was difficult over there at Cambridge. Inadequate food, lot of hard work, strenuous work and loneliness, living all alone away from the family becomes very difficult for him, and he fell ill. He came back to India, but he died on 26, 1920. As a part of year-long celebration to mark 125th birth anniversary of Ramanujan, the Ramanujan Mathematical Society held a series of activity that year. So to celebrate his 125th birth anniversary, Ramanujan Mathematical Society, they undertook various activities particularly in that year. The Mathematics Center named after Ramanujan was set up in Chennai. So one entire Mathematics Center was set up in Chennai. It has a host of facilities including a museum. A documentary tracing the history of mathematics in India was also made. Efforts will also be made to bring out the biography of Ramanujan by Robert Cangill under the title The Man Who Knew Infinity, A Life of a Genius, Ramanujan in English. So in that center, mathematical center, there was a museum, there was a history of how the mathematics in India has developed, has grown. And also a documentary will be made, a biography, a movie will be made of Ramanujan on the name The Man Who Knew Infinity, A Life of the Genius Ramanujan in English. So these are the achievements and the things that Ramanujan had, Srinivas Ramanujan had made in his entire tenure. In his entire life, he lived only for a very short period of life, that is for 32 years. But he was so good in maths, and he was not that much good in other subjects, but he was very good in maths.